it's Elisa. How are you doing? I hope you're good. Is it okay if I send you a text or a voice note or something? I know you're really busy, but it's something really private. I just needed you reassurance about some stuff that's been happening with me right now, and I need you to just make sure that I'm okay. By polar opposite contrast. I also got a job straight out of school, as I mentioned, and fell in line. Somehow I kind of liked the stability of a corporate job. And, you know, that sort of order that it brought, but not only order, there's a part of me that kind of got excited when I saw that, you know, if I work a little longer, a couple more years, I could also get that special parking spot that the managers had, and I could get a really nice office one day and things like that. And then I met Brian. He joined the same company as I did a couple years after me, and we started dating, fell in love, got married, had three miscarriages before I conceived Chelsea. And Brian saw how devoted I was to motherhood, and he just said, you know, Eva, just stay home with her. Leave your job, stay home with her. And I did. And that was when everything stopped and shifted. The financial burden really got to Brian. I don't think he had the heart to tell me, hey, go back to work. And I think he kind of just saw his life at 35, 36, now 37, just stagnate. It just became repeat, rinse, repeat, rinse, repeat, work, work, work. Work, 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 work. Take care of this family, take care of this family, take care of this family. And there was no room left for him. And I slowly saw him disappear from me. And me, it's hard taking care of a baby, you know? But there are quiet moments. And they are lethal if you have nothing going on in your life. Nothing that's you anymore. It's now over 10, 15 years since I left fashion design behind. Since I decided to walk away from my passion. So far, recessed. Removed from me that I can't even recall anything much about that desire. The only way I could catch a glimpse of it is if I kind of live vicariously through Elisa's heart and her eyes that light up every time she speaks about Hollywood or going on a tour of Universal Studios or Paramount or something that just excites her.